Now, back here in Washington, the fight over the wall funding, well, it's getting nastier by the day. It seems like at a total impasse. And the attacks are more personal as we head into day 21 of the government shutdown.
He's holding the American people hostage as leverage.
His shutdown government takes pride in it.
I find China, frankly, in many ways, to be far more honorable than Brian, Chuck, and Nancy. I really do. I think that China is actually much easier to deal with than the opposition party.
This is actually a pretty good line. House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy, I keep saying Majority Leader, got to get it back, joins me now with the reaction. Okay. We painted the picture of what they do. It's emotional manipulation on the Trump is cruel. But then when there's real cruelty, death and destruction, suffering to the American people, Democrats are like, well, yeah, there's some crime, but. And they make excuses. Where are we tonight?
Well, first of all, I hope every Democrat that serves right over there watched your show tonight. I hope they watched the Pierce's parents. Because when we're sitting in these meetings in the Situation Room, and the Secretary of Homeland tries to provide the facts, Speaker Pelosi will just interrupt because she doesn't want to hear it. When I would bring up Officer Singh, because Speaker Pelosi and I come from the same state, the individual who killed Officer Singh was arrested in my county. Why? Because he was on his way to Mexico. How can you say it's not a crisis? How can you say it? And the Democrats, everyone in that room, you know what they say? They're for border security. And I ask, what is your definition? Who believes if you're for border security, there's not some form of barrier that protects you?
Oh, they used to be for border security. But I think it's time to stop allowing them to say that. I mean, no, you're not. Because you used to be, and now you say the position you used to have is cruel. So, I mean, I'm playing all those old Obama bites. I mean, you've seen those.
Oh, he says it's a crisis, 2014. No, humanitarian.
Yeah, but 2005, that was like Donald Trump speaking. He's like, they got to keep him out of the country. We have to stop the flow in. And now it's like completely changed dynamic. Now, the Democrats are itching, I think, at least a core number, not the leadership perhaps, but itching to try to move this toward impeachment. They want to use the shutdown as a quiver in their, as an arrow in their impeachment quiver. Do you think that that is true? And do you think they're going to get anywhere with it?
I think they want to impeach regardless of anything. They showed it on their first day. What'd they do? They introduced impeachment. What do they do when you go and watch the congresswoman from Michigan sitting in her own little rally there talking about what she wants to have happen? This is their whole campaign of why they ran. They want to impeach, they want to eliminate ICE, and they want to get Medicare for all. That's what they said, and that's what they're trying to. But they're not going to get anywhere. You can't impeach an individual that has not done anything in the process. They won't go anywhere in the Senate. But most importantly, I think the American public won't put up with it either. Because you see what Speaker Pelosi did? She tried to backpedal away when they're all talking about impeachment. They want to build to it, but I do not believe they'll be
successful. This is Mazie Hirono. You guys work out together, right? She's one of your pals, a senator from Hawaii.
No. We don't work out with her.
No, I'm just saying, Mazie Hirono, last seen at the Kavanaugh hearings, doing such a good job, talking about the vanity wall. I mean, apparently it's just going to be called Trump wall, like the big T-R-U-M-P on it. Let's watch.
This is a vanity wall, and he's caused a government shutdown so that he can get his wall. 800,000 people are being held hostage by this president who makes no distinction between right or wrong. He doesn't care.
Well, speaking of doesn't care, going dovetailing back to our point, they don't care about the victims. You met with the president. How serious is he about trying to get to yes here? And who's operating? I mean, it sounds like it's a loaded question, but it seems like he's actually tried to compromise. He's like practically done anything but bake them cookies to try to get them to negotiate.
He didn't bake them cookies, but he brought them candy. He walked in the room with candy. He gave it to Chuck. And he said, everybody else share around the room. This is a man that every single day has brought them back together, worked throughout the weekend, gave them idea after idea. And he was calm as can be. And then we looked at Nancy when she kept saying no. He said, okay, if I do what you want, if we open government back up in 30 days, could we have anything on the wall? She said, no, not at all. He says, okay, there's nothing here, and got up and walked away.
They want this shutdown to continue. Do you agree with that?
Remember, this shutdown never had to take place. It took 60 votes in the Senate, Schumer created the shutdown. They wanted to have this shutdown. And remember what we're fighting over, 10% of what we spent last year to foreign aid to other countries.
No. This is their entertainment budget for a few years. Kevin McCarthy, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Democrats have refused to listen to the border agents, and they say this is a manufactured crisis. That's their new soundbite. All over, I turned the television. You know, I call it the opposition party. It's called the fake news media. And what happens is every network has manufactured crisis. This is a man, every one of them. It's like they, you know, send out to everybody, let's use this soundbite today. So it's a manufacturer, but it's not.
All right, that was President Trump today at a roundtable on immigration and border security in McAllen, Texas. Earlier today at the border, I talked to the Texas senators, Ted Cruz and John Cornyn, about this border crisis. Take a look. Senator, you came here. This, right over my shoulder.
Yeah.
It's like a two-minute walk. Literally, you can walk across the Rio Grande.
Yeah.
And we saw the drugs when I was interviewing the president.
Yeah.
This is happening every day here.
Right. Look, this is over 500 pounds of drugs that was intercepted right here. I think this trip was very valuable. I was pleased to come down with the president to meet with Border Patrol, but also to meet with victims whose family had lost their lives to illegal immigration. There are real human tragedies. And when you see Chuck Schumer and the Democrats force a government shutdown because they are so adamantly opposed to securing the border, that's really out of touch, and it's not where the American people are.
You know, I sat in a briefing here in this very sector, and come on over, Senator, we'll say hi to you as well. Senator Cornyn is welcome. How are you, my friend?
I'm good.
I was just telling Senator Cruz, last time I was down here, I've been to the border 14 times from the Rio Grande to San Diego, but I sat in a security briefing with Governor Perry at the time. And in a seven-year period in this state, 642,000 crimes committed against Texans, some petty crimes, but it included murders and rapes. This is a huge problem. This is life and death. How long should the president be holding out? I know some in the Senate are getting a little nervous about reopening the government for furloughed employees.
Well, I think the president's advice to us is to stay strong, and we will. We're not going to fold. We're on the right side of this argument, as Ted and I both know. We've talked to families affected by crime. We've talked, to the law enforcement, Border Patrol, to the migrants themselves who get raped, robbed, and murdered in the hands of some of the criminal cartels. I don't think people fully comprehend it, so I'm glad the president's down here to bring the point home. This is not just about economic migrants. It's about illegal drugs. It's about human trafficking. It's about crime. And so it's really important that he's here.
You know, the idea that somehow people are making the argument that this is manufactured. We just lost Officer Singh. We lost a young kid in Knoxville, Tennessee named Pierce Corcoran. I interviewed his parents. Their lives will never be the same again. They lost a 22-year-old kid. There seems to be a callousness or a disconnect. We're losing 300 Americans a week because of the heroin and the opioid epidemic, 90% coming through this border.
Well, look, Officer Singh's brother joined us for the roundtable, and he was grieving at his brother. And it's worth noting, both he and his brother, they are themselves immigrants, but they came the right way. They came legally, seeking the American dream, and his brother wanted to be a cop, wanted to keep people safe, and he lost his life to a criminal illegal alien. And you know, the Democrats, they masquerade, they try to cloak their support for open borders by saying it's compassionate. Sean, it is not compassionate to want even a single little boy or single little girl in the custody of human traffickers. Nobody, look, you and I both have kids. No one wants to see a teenage girl's in the custody of human traffickers that do unspeakable things. You know what the compassionate thing to do is? Secure this border and stop illegal immigration and stop the drug trafficking.
Well, Democrats did politicize it when they talked about family separation. The separations you're discussing are permanent separations.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
That can never be fixed. So the Democrats, they don't seem to want to negotiate at all. What's the next step? And should the president just hold strong and wait till they come to the table?
Well, unfortunately, in addition to everything you've discussed, we have about 800,000 federal employees that are wondering how do they pay their mortgage, how are they going to put food on the table. Completely unnecessary, collateral damage. This is a dispute that could be resolved in the next 30 minutes if Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer actually wanted to negotiate in good faith. The president's
But didn't they support it in 2006 and 2013? Oh,
absolutely.
They sounded like Trump.
Well, Hillary Clinton, Barack Obama, Chuck Schumer all supported the Secure Fence Act in 2006. And again, during the Gang of Eight immigration bill, they voted for $50 million worth of Border Patrol.
2013.
Border, yeah. 2013.
And it's even more than that. Look, the president is asking for a little over $5 billion in border security and to build a barrier.
Mm-hmm.
And the Democrats have said, Chuck Schumer and Nancy Pelosi have said, hell no, not one penny that goes to a wall. Their objection isn't on substance. I mean, Schumer and the rest of them voted for $40 billion just a few years ago. Their objection is pure politics. They hate the president. Their left-wing base hates the president. And Chuck Schumer, this is now the second Schumer shutdown in a year. He forced one earlier because he wanted to see amnesty. He forced the second one because he wants to see open borders. And, you know, I know you watched the president's address earlier this week, and then... Schumer and Pelosi's.
The Saturday Night Live skit that followed?
If Saturday Night Live were remotely fair, that would be their opening, but they won't make fun of Democrats, so I promise you they won't do it.
They have to. It would be impossible to be that biased.
Look, I gotta say, though, that thing, when I saw Schumer and Pelosi, that thing looks like a hostage video.
No, I see, hostage videos can be more compelling.
And I am just about certain, if you watch it again in slow motion, Nancy is blinking SOS as Schumer is talking. I mean, they know they're in the wrong, and the American people know they're in
the
wrong.
You think this will turn around? You expecting a breakthrough? We haven't, look, yesterday, if they say no to the wall, nothing. I know the president pretty well. I think he's going to stand firm as long as the Senate does. Mitch McConnell's standing strong. Lindsey Graham's standing strong. You're standing with the president.
We'll stand strong. I think once Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer's caucus starts to hear from their constituents who are having trouble paying their bills and putting food on the table, I think they'll crater.
Well, thank you.
And I'll say, look, to furloughed federal employees, they're going to receive their back pay.
The president said he supports that.
Absolutely. Yeah. They're going to receive their back pay. Now, they should be paid today. Schumer needs to end this shutdown. But, you know, yesterday the president came to the Senate, had lunch with all the Senate Republicans, and it was striking. There was a unity. We were standing together. We were unified. And I'm grateful the president has helped really infuse some spinal fortitude. And I think the Democrats are starting to panic because the position they're taking, it's not reasonable and it's not right.
We can't have any more Americans being killed by people that didn't respect our laws and sovereignty. And this opioid epidemic, those drugs that have flown into this country, they're going to every small town and big city across this country, and 90% of it is from right over there.
That's right.
So it's got to stop. Yeah, the heroin with fentanyl.
Right. Wow, that's scary. The heroin and fentanyl, you're right. More than 70,000 people died of drug overdoses. A lot of that was opioids coming from across the border.
Right.
And as you said, Sean, 90% of the heroin coming from Mexico. So this is a humanitarian crisis, and it is a national security crisis.
Life and death.
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you both. Appreciate the time. Thank you, sir.
Thanks,
Senator, good to see you again.